myself, Shweta Shah, and I'm your instructor for the subject microprocessor and microcontroller. In this subject, we have started Unit 4, that is AVR Assembly Language Programming. And in this session, we are going to see further the example based on the data transfer, arithmetic, and logical instruction. So let us start with the example. In this example, we have to write the assembly language program for multiplication of two 8-bit numbers and store this result to the memory. Okay, in this first we have to load this number inside some register, and then we can use the MUL instruction to multiply two numbers, and then we have to store that result that is already in register 0 and register 1 to some memory location. Okay, so first let us start with the loading of that number. So for this we can use the LDI instruction, in which we have to use LDI, then some register and the immediate data. This immediate data is going to be stored inside the register. Okay, so here first instruction is LDI R17,90. So this 90 is going to be stored inside the register R70. Then we can use the second register for storing the second data, and for this we are using the LDI R18,30. This will store this 30 into the register R80. Next we have the MUL instruction, in which we have like MUL R17,R18. This will do the multiplication of the resistors contained of R17 and R18, and result is going to be stored inside the resistor R1 and R0. R1 will be MSB and R0 will be LSB. Okay, so after this we will have like 00 inside the resistor R1 and 1B inside the resistor R0. Okay, then we are say that we have to store this result inside some memory location. So we have to use the instructions like STS, which will store the content to some location. For this we have to provide the opcode, then the address where you want to store the data, and then the resistor whose content you want to store at that memory location. So we have to store the content of resistor R0 and R1, and we are randomly choosing the location 200 and 201. So our instruction will be like STS 200,R0. This will store the content of register 0 and R0 to location 200, and then we have to use the instruction STS 201,R1. This will store the content of register R1 to the location 201. Okay, so this is the basically multiplication operation, where first we have to load this number inside some register, then use the MUL instruction for multiplication, but result is inside the register R0 and R1, but we have to store it to some memory location, so we will use the STS instruction for storing that result. Okay, so this is the basic multiplication operation. Next we will see the another example, in which we have to write the assembly language program for addition of two 16-bit numbers and store this sum to some memory location. Okay, and data is given like first data of 16-bit is like 3CE7 and second data is 3B8E. Okay, so we have to add this two 16-bit data by using this 8-bit resistors and 8-bit controller. Okay, so first we have to store this data in some register. So this is the 16-bit data, but we have registers that can contain only 8 bits. So we have to store this 16-bit data inside two registers. Okay, so we can use any register, but for simplicity we are using the R1, R2, R3, R4 for storing this data. Okay, so first 8D is going to be stored inside the register R1. So for this we have instruction LDI R1,8D. This will store the 8D data inside the register R1. Similarly, we can use R2, R3, R4 for another data. So in R2 we are storing 3B, R3 we are storing 3E7, and R4 we are storing 3C. Okay, now if we do the addition, then we have to first add this 8D and 7E. Okay, and then we have to add 3C and 3B. But in first addition, that is of E7 and 8D, if any carry is generated, then we have to add that carry into the second addition, that is of 3C and 3B. Okay, so first we will use the add instruction, and then second, in second addition of 3B and 3C, we have to use the add with carry instruction. Okay, so our first data, that is E7 and ED, that we have stored inside the register R1 and R3. So first we will use the instruction add R3,RD. This will add the content of register R3 and R1, and result is going to be stored inside the register R3. Okay, so our first addition of 3 8D and 3 E7 is there, and result is inside the register R3. Then we will use the instruction ADC. If any carry is generated with this addition, that is of AD and E7, so result is like 74 and carry is 1. Next, for next addition, we will add the 3C and 3D, in which we have to use the ADC instruction, because in previous case there can be carry generated. Okay, so we have instruction like ADC R4, R2. This will add the content of R4 and R2, and result is stored inside the register R4. So the result will be like 7, 8, and that is stored inside the register R4. So after this instruction, we have to store this result inside some memory location. Okay. So for this, we have to use the STC instruction. So first we will use the 200 location and then 201 location. So STC 200 comma R3, this will store the content of register 3, that is the first addition, at memory location 200, and then we will use the instruction STS 201 comma R4. This will store the second addition result to location 201. Okay. So by this way, first we have added the lower byte and then we have added the upper byte, but with addition with carry instruction. Okay, and lastly we have to store this content at memory location by using the STS instruction. Okay, then we will see next example. In next example, we have to write the program for subtraction of 18 hex from 29 hex, and we have to store this result in R21 register, and we have to perform this operation by two ways. First one without using the SUBI instruction, and second one with using SUBI instruction. Here SUBI instruction is subtract with immediate data. Okay, where you are providing the immediate data which you want to subtract from the first register. Okay, so we have to perform this subtraction operation by using this SUBI instruction or without. Okay, first let us see without SUBI instructions. So first of all, we have to load these numbers inside some register, and then we can use the SUB instruction, subtraction instruction. Okay, so first we will load in register R21 and then second data into the R22. So first instruction is LDI R21 comma 0 cross 29. This will store this 29 inside the register R21. And then we will use the instruction LDI R22 comma 0 cross 18. This will store this 18 inside the register R22. Okay, so our data is stored inside the register R21 and R22. Now simply we have to use the subtraction instruction, that is SUB R21 comma R22. This will subtract the content of register 22 from the register 21, and result is stored inside the register 21. Okay, so this is the basic subtraction operation, but result is inside the register 21. Okay, this is the first case. In second case, we are going to using SUBI instruction, where in first case we have to store both of this data, that 29 as well as 18, inside some register. But when you can use the second data as an immediate data, then you require to store only one register then. Okay, so first we will store the content that is 29, and 18 we will use as an immediate data. Okay, for this subtraction. So first of all, we have to load this number inside one register, and similarly for previous case we are using the R21 register. So here first we have to use LDI R21 comma 0 cross 29. This will store this 29 inside the register R21. After this storing, we can directly use the instruction SUBI R21 comma 0 cross 18. This will use this 18 as immediate data and subtract this from this content of register R21, where we have already stored the 29. Okay, so this both of these things result will be same, but in this case we have to load both of this data inside some register, and in this case we have to load only one data inside register, and second data we can use as an immediate data for the subtraction. Okay, so this is the method how we can use the SUBI instruction. Next we will see another example in which we have to perform the subtraction operation of 16 bit data, which we are given the 16-bit data, and we have to subtract that 20 and store the result inside the register 20 and register 21. In register 21, we have to store the higher byte, and register 20, we have to store the lower byte. Okay, so first of all, we have to store this data. In similar case which we have used for the addition of 16-bit data, we have to store this data inside 4 register, and that we will use like R20, 21 and 19 and 8. First of all, we will use the instruction LDI R20, 9A. This will store the 9A inside the register 20. Then we will use the instruction LDI R21, 7F. This will store this 7F inside the register 21. So our first data, that is 7F9A, that is going to be stored inside the register 21 and 20. Okay, then we will store this BC48 inside the register R19 and R18. So first content is inside the register R19. For this we have instruction LDI R19, 48. This will store this 48 inside the register R19. And then we can use the instruction LDI R18, BC. This will store this BC inside the register R18. So this is the basically 4 instructions to store this 16-bit data inside some register. Okay, here instead of R19 and R18 you can use any register. Okay, then we will do the subtraction operation. In first we have to subtract the content 9A and 48. That 9A we have stored inside the register R20 and 48 we have stored inside the register R19. So our subtraction operation will be like SUB R20, R19. This will subtract 9A and 48, and result is going to be stored inside the register R20, which is required, which is our lower byte, and that is stored inside the R20 register. Then we will use the another subtraction operation, but this time we have to consider if any borrow is generated while first subtraction. So our instruction will be like subtraction with borrow. So for this we have SBC R21, R18. This will subtract the content 7F and BC with previous borrow. If any borrow is generated, then that is also going to be subtracted over here. Okay. So this is the basically 16-bit subtraction operation for the data. Next, we will see the logical instructions. There are many logical instructions like ANDing, ORing, XORing, or you can say compare, 2's complement. That kind of logical operations can be performed inside the controller. Okay, so we will see the syntax for each and every this logical instructions. For AND, we have instruction like AND. Opcode is like AND. Then RD, RR. Here RD is the destination register and RR is the resource register. So here the OR ending of RD and RR register is done, and result is going to be stored inside the register RD. That is your first register. Okay. And here the operation is done bitwise. Okay. For example, if we have the instruction like LDI R20, 35, this will load the 20. Register with the content 35, and then we can use the instruction ANDI. This is similar to AND instruction, but in AND your both of these content are inside some register, but in ANDI instruction you can put one data as an immediate data. Okay, so that is also possible inside in this AND instruction. So here we have instruction ANDI R20, 0F. This will do the ending operation of content of register 20 and 0F, and result is going to be stored inside the register 20. Okay, here the operation is going to be performed bitwise. So if we write the bit pattern for 35, then this will be like 00110101, and for F we have pattern like 0000 and 1111. Okay, so in ending each and every bit at each and every position are going to be ended, and result is going to be stored inside the register R20 at particular position. So for first 1 and 1 ended, result is 1, 0 and 1 ended, result is 0, 1 and 1 result is 1, 0 and 1, 0, and similar for another 4 bits. So this will be like, result will be like 0, 5, and that is going to be stored inside the register R20. And in this case, there is also possibility that your flags are affected. So after the operation, whichever content is generated, depending upon that, your flags are going to be set or reset. For this case, we can see that result is not 0. So your 0 flag will be reset. And you are not passing any carry from lower byte to upper byte. So your edge flag will be 0. And this result is not negative, so your negative flag is 0. Okay, and so depending upon your result, your flags are going to be affected. Okay, next we can see another instruction, that is the OR instruction. This is similar to ANDing, but your operation performed is of ORing. syntax is same, like OR, that is opcode, then RD, RR. Here RD is the destination resistor and RR is the resource resistor. So operation will be like RD is equals to RD or RR. Okay, that is similar to AND operation. Then you can use the XORing operation, and it is also having the same syntax, that is XOR, RD, RR. Here the XORing of RD and RR resistors contain is done, and result is going to be stored inside the resistor RD. Next, in this we can write it like this. For example, we have the first contain inside the resistor R20 by using the instruction LDI R20,054. This will store this 54 inside the resistor 20. Then we can use the instruction LDI R21,078. It will store the 78 inside the resistor R21. So our contain is stored inside the resistor R20 and R21. After this, we can use the instruction XOR R20,R21. This will do the XORing of this contain of two resistors, and result is going to be stored inside the resistor R20. So here we have, suppose we have data like 54 and 78. So bit pattern will be like this, and bit wise XORing of this contain is done, and result is going to be stored inside the resistor 20. And here also there is possibility of changing of flag depending upon your operands. So whatever result is generated, depending upon that result, your flags are going to be affected. Okay, so this is the logical instruction for XORing operation. Then you can use the instructions for the complement and negative. This complement is like one's complement, where whichever bit pattern you have stored inside the resistor, its content is going to be complemented. So wherever there is 1, it is replaced by 0, and wherever it is 0, it is replaced by 1. So this is the instruction for complement of the content of resistors, and the syntax for this instruction is like COMRD. RD is your destination resistor whose content you want to change. And for example, if we can write like this, LDI R20,0 × AA, it will store the AA contained inside the resistor 20. And after this, if we write the instruction like COMR20, this will complement the content of resistor 20, that is AA is going to be complemented. If you complement AA, you will get the 55. Okay, so after this instruction, the content of resistor 20 will be 55. Okay, next we can see the negative instruction. In this instruction, it will take the 2's complement. In complement instruction, you are doing the 1's complement, while in a negate instruction, you will do the 2's complement. For this syntax is like NEGRD. This will complement the content of some that particular resistor that you have provided. For example, if we are using the instruction like LDI R21,0 × 85, it will first store 85 inside the resistor R1. R21, then we will use the instruction NEG R21. This will do the 2's complement of the content of resistor R21. So for 2's complement, we have written like this. First we have written this bit pattern, then 1's complement, that is replacing all 1's by 0's and 0's by 1, and then adding 1 into it. So we will get it like 7B. So the 2's complement of the 85 that we have stored inside the resistor R21 is going to be replaced by this 2's complement, that is 7B. Okay, so this is the negate instruction which you can use for find out the 2's complement of any number. Complement is for 1's complement and negate is for 2's complement. Other than this, we can use this compare instruction for comparing the content of two resistors. In this, we have syntax like CP RD, RR. It will compare the content of resistor RD and resistor RR. Here, for comparison, subtraction operation is going to be done, but no operands are changed. Operands will remain as it is, but just only comparison operation, for comparison operation, subtraction operation will be performed, and depending upon that, your flags are going to be affected. Your operands will remain as it is. The content of resistor RD and RR will remain as it is. Only flags are affected. And you can also use the instruction like CPI RD, K. Here you are comparing the content of resistor RD with immediate data that you have provided inside the instruction, that K is your immediate data. Okay. So you can also use this compare instruction for your logical task. So here we are ending our today's session. If you have any query, then you can contact me.